Guest of honor, Her Excellency, dating Kadugas Seri Rasmanusul, the Honorable Datuk Kamal Kesal Talib, City Mayor of Kuala Lumpur. By the way, Mr. Mayor, you look so handsome in your barong. His Excellency Nasser Salman Al Abudi, Dean of the Diplomatic Corps, Honorable Deputy Secretary General Sabin Das of Ms. Aputra, the Honorable Datuk Wira Abu Seman Yusuf, Deputy Minister of Home Affairs, my colleagues, their excellencies in the Diplomatic Corps, members of the Malaysia-Philippine Business Council, the members of the Kelab Asian Institute of Management, ladies and gentlemen, indeed, I think tonight is a lovely evening for music. Christina and I and the Philippine Embassy staff are truly delighted to have all of you here with us tonight. Most especially, of course, our guest of honor, Datin Rosa Mansur, who was also in Manila together with Prime Minister Najib last week. I have been in Kuala Lumpur for almost a year, and judging from the headline stories in the local papers here, I think I can say that it is indeed a great time to be a Philippine ambassador to Kuala Lumpur. This is so because there are so many, many positive developments taking place. As the photo montage showed, in the last few days, the world witnessed the beginning of a new dawn for Filipinos in Mindanao. The signing of the much-anticipated framework agreement with the Moro Islamic Liberation Front, made possible by the able facilitation of Malaysia, affirmed the Filipino people's resolve, commitment, and yearning for peace. It signals the closing of the curtain on violence and the opening of doors to peaceful coexistence and harmony among Muslims, the Lumad indigenous communities, Christians, and all others that comprise the wondrous tapestry of one Filipino nation. Now more than ever, we think that the sound of peace echo like music to the ears of Filipinos of the Bangsa Moro, embracing the prospects of what a united and peaceful land can offer for generations. There have been celebrations, of course, in the Philippines, most especially in Manila and in Mindanao. It is therefore fitting that we bring the joy to and have a celebration in Malaysia, which played a pivotal role in the quest for peace. The successful peace process made more special by the presence of Prime Minister Najib and Datin Rosman in Manila marks also an important milestone in Philippine-Malaysian relations. This cultural exchange event, which I and the good mayor billed as a celebration of peace, is a tribute to the Philippines' friendship and abiding partnership with Malaysia, as well as all others which have been our partners in the peacemaking process. And I'd like to make special mention of the members of the International Contact Group for Mindanao, which is composed of the governments of the United Kingdom. If there are, you know, officers or representatives from those embassies, just maybe stand up or make a little noise. United Kingdom, Japan, Turkey, Saudi Arabia, and the international NGOs, the Conciliation Resources, the Center for Humanitarian Dialogue, the Asia Foundation, and Muhammadiyah. We also thank the members of the International Monitoring Team, composed of the governments of Malaysia, which is the head of that team, Brunei, Libya, Norway, Indonesia, the European Union, and Japan. To celebrate the dawn of peace in Mindanao and a new phase in Philippine-Malaysian relations, the Embassy of the Philippines, in cooperation with Mayor Datuk Ahmad Kesal Talib, takes pride in presenting to you one of the world's best in music, the University of the Philippines Concert Chorus, whose 50 years of unparalleled musical virtuosity and versatility has brought joy to countless music lovers. The gift of music heals divisions, promotes peace, and unites peoples. It moves, enchants, amazes, and brings out the best in each person. Henry David Thoreau once said that, and I quote, "In a world of peace and love, music would be the universal language." Before we bring on stage the University of the Philippines Concert Chorus, let me present to you a short video clip about the beautiful land from which I and the chorus members come from, and why, as our tourism tagline says, it is fun in the Philippines. Maraming salamat po, terima kasih. Do enjoy the show.